Alright guys, welcome to another tutorial. Sorry for taking so long. So we're going to study row layout. So we're starting with the layout and we're starting with row layout because it's quite easy to understand. It's quite easy to explain to you. We're going to create a row layout. You can use it for... you can actually use it for... navigation, but I'm actually going to where I installed Python. I installed Anaconda. I have Python and Anaconda installed. I'm actually going to where I installed PyQt. PyQt, so I can find my KMS in there. And I'm already in Anaconda 4. You can actually use search to find KMS. You're looking for KMS because it's faster. To use it to run your QML, right? So yes, we're gonna start by creating just one QML file. I'll call it really, I just call it our parameter, and I change it to .QML. Forgive me for any noise you hear outside, it's not really my fault. I have a very terrible sound. Anyway, so I'm going to drag and drop into my... I have a Qt designer, you don't have to, but you can use your own text editor, but it gives me highlighting and syntax that I explained in a previous video. I'm also going to use QMLC to run my code, so I'm going to drag and drop it here. You can see I already navigated into where QMLC has been installed, where my PyQt is installed, and the folder where my PyQt is installed, and I found KMS in, and I'm just using it to run, but now it won't run because I have almost nothing in there, and I'm going to start putting things in the PyQt quick. 2.4 PyQt quick. So yeah, application maybe without this you might not see anything. It might cause trouble, you might not see anything. So yeah, the first thing you need here, visible true, and then you need a written height. 1024 height, these are just normal 480, and then you need a title, which is why I'm gonna go to the shop store, you know. CC 2018, yeah, just so you know exactly what's going on. And before we do our roll layout, so supposing I'm building, I want a navigation, even I don't want a navigation. The roll layout, it's using to do something like this, a row, and then you lay out. So everything in there, it's actually in one column. There's a column, there's another column, there's a column, column. But before you use it, literally do a roll layout. And everything is for everything in there. Sorry for confusing you with that way. I know it's a little bit confusing. And so go to the right hand drop so that I can color in everything. You can color really out. Rectangle. I'm gonna set the parent of width. So that it's when the width of the parent changes, it changes for it. And I mean it fits perfectly. Parent dot. I'm not going to do it. I will do 140. No, I will do 160 because our multiples are 4. And now I will run it. You can see our press enter. You can see it's running. There is it's already white. We can actually change the color of the application window. I forgot to make it 3 3 3 3 3 3. And then I'll see my height better. You can see it is the application window, yeah. But I don't even want to keep it. I know I've not set a color for it. I want to set a color. I want to make it black. It's one of the main reasons why I even created a rectangle first. Black. Yeah. Right, so here we are, rectangle, now we can go ahead, it's filling the color for us. It's now, when I change it, the red light it's working, it's filling. If I change it to a fixed width, like to 1024 like this, just like this guy, I'm gonna have problems. So here we are, it fits in a 1024, but boom, when I enlarge it, it doesn't fit, and you know that we don't want that. So here we go, right? The width, and then boom, that's what we want. And so it's because of the color, I created a rectangle first, yeah, just to explain the row layout only. So we're gonna create a row layout with things like this in there. So first you put it, put your row layout in there. You can put it row layout everywhere, wherever you want it, inside this guy, inside the application we're working for anyway. So really, what does it take? It needs a width and height, and then the things in there and some few other information. So width and height, what's gonna be the width? Period, the width. Height, what's gonna be the height? Period, the height. And we can't see anything because it's just a layout, there's nothing in there. So yes, you can see, of course. You can give it a color. I have a highlighting ID or any given color, it's gonna tell you illegal name palette. And so we're gonna put rectangles in there. Rectangles in there. And so we're gonna put a first rectangle. And it's all about color. I'm gonna use color dodgy blue. There we go. Wrong spelling, dodgy blue. Width. So introducing width 50. You're gonna laugh at me. I don't want to keep long on this talk, so let me talk. Now, when you have a layout, you see layout, there's row layout, there's column layout, there's grid layout, and when we see layout, it means that each children can have a new property called layout or something. So layout of field width, layout of field height, and then it will allow it to just snap, like the parent of width is snapping. But it can do a little bit more. So I'll say layout of field width true, and then I need a height before I can see anything. If I don't do a height, if I won't see anything, because that's good enough for you. I will not do the height and I'll run. I will not see anything, though I have the color. Now height of, what is the height? Height of 50. I think it's a good time to explain to you the layout of height. Height true to, and I mean, you know what's gonna happen, it's gonna feel the height, gonna, and when I snap it, it's gonna just gonna go ahead and snap rather than doing the width and height that will work. But when I snap it, it will not be snapping, and it will wait for this one, and then I'll be snapping, and it will not be snapping. And that's what these guys are, but it does a little bit more, so it's feeling good. If I have two or three in there, sometimes you can really get a lot. Let me add one. Let me see. Change this color to green. Now, what should I give this guy? I don't know what color to give. I don't really remember much of the ECM colors. Boom, now you can see. This is what I wanted to show you. So, all of them, I said before, I want to show you the row layout has a lot of key spacing. You can change the documentation for any other thing. So spaces set to zero, you show the spaces within, but the spaces are gone. Now what is that space doing there? It's supposed to be gone, space is zero. And it was in there. Anyway, I have no idea how to take away. You can see this one is gone, I'm not sure, I don't know what. The other guy is not gone. Anyway, so feel height. It's because these guys are multiples of 4, and these guys are just 3. So probably there's something wrong with the decimal center. I will make it rather 4. I don't know if you're gonna kill me for making a 4. There we go, I'm gonna change this guy to color red. I hate the color red. Boom, now you can see it's almost, it's all gone. Now you can see how small they are. They are all set to feel weak. Yes, I know that that's exactly what we want. Oh, I don't know. They all set to fill with, but they are snapping together with each other, and when you enlarge it, it's sizes, the sizes of them increases, but they are still agreeing with one another. It gets beautiful. Suppose I want to change one of them, like the first one. From, I want to add something super cool, layout of Mazda. Width, and I set it to 700. That's terrible. I want to do layout of minimum. Sorry for flopping like that. I do minimum. What is your minimum? Layout of minimum width down. Ta da! Look at that. Cool. Boom, boom, boom. Now, what's going on is that that fool is filling me up. The layout minimum is supposed to flop. I'm gonna fix it. This figure is quite too high. And therefore, it's still doing the same foolishness. And I will say it's preferred width. I think we're gonna go preferred width to 400. Something you get on the same nonsense. Alright, I think it's because we have four in there. Deleting one, deleting two. So I'm gonna show you the preferred, the layout settings of the preferred. I don't know what's treating you like that. I mean, it's the same nonsense. Something is so difficult. Feel with it. Now, okay, I think what's wrong is that it also has a feel with it. And I'm picking a feel with it up. Around 700. I hope this will be like a day. You can see I have a feet, I have what I want. Now, sorry for doing the thing I did feel with. I did rehearse, but I don't want to zoom that to me. So here we have the feel with. Now you can see this one is increasing in size, and the rest of them are sharing the remaining size, but this one is already taken because we've set it to minimum size. When you go, it's not going to work because that's the minimum size. I tell you, the window has been so affected. Forgive me for the noise. It's the same for maximum. Maximum. Wait, what is going on? Maximum weight. And we got the maximum decided to give me a treat. That's the same nonsense. There's a terrible copy effect which you're supposed to avoid. But here am I teaching you how to use it. As you can see, it's using a preferred word that I hate. I hate a preferred word. It's bad. So you can do your, let me do a normal width so that you can really see this thing well. I hope that's that material flow. Good. Now you can see we have a width. I'm changing this guy's width. I will make it so huge, you'll be glad. And boom, here's what I want you to see. You can see this guy's width is static, 1,000, and everybody else is just flopping to join with them. Until the window is affected, this guy will not be affected. And you can see that this guy is just taking a start, and these guys are sharing the rest. Because of their fill width, they can all be given a minimum width and things like that. Normally, when you have the fill height to set, it misbehaves. Tell us why I'm having problems. I'm touching it. This guy's layout of minimum width to a little bit up. I can't wait. So, yes, if they agree, they all sharing the rest. This guy has a minimum width, this guy has a the width itself, we have given them a maximum width, and you can see until they are really affected by the window, they will not show signs of it. And this is a bloody tutorial. I'm gonna make the next one better. I promise you're gonna get a better metal. Forgive me for the noises, forgive me for the sound. I'm not gonna edit the video because I have a problem with my video editor. And sorry for the noises. See you in the next video. I'm not gonna remake this one because it's an easy thing, and if you only know your layout, you're not gonna be able to do something big. So we're gonna talk about it and polish up in the upcoming video. So thank you. You can also read the docs at docs.qt.io. See you. Bye. Bye.